Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Zoe, and today we will be playing a very new game, Lost Words Beyond the Page. This is my first time trying it. It is on Xbox Game Pass console, so if you'd like to try it, you can easily do that. Otherwise, let's get started. Let's get started. Right. Gameplay. Curse sensitivity. Why not? Open book, up, jump, run left, run right, blah, blah, blah. Crouch, grab scrap, interact, B, etc, etc, etc. English. Why not? Yeah, let's go with it. I think everything's good. New game. Let's go!
Belongs to me.
Okay.
Hi, journal. Is it okay if I call you that? It's a bit formal, I know. But we've only just met. Let me introduce myself.
What's up it up there? I can't get there.
I'm Isabel Barbara Cook. Most people call me Izzy, not Dad. He calls me Titch. He's such a numpty head.
Aww.
My little brother Ben calls me Isbo. I call him He Who Chews Curtains. He likes red for breakfast and blue for dinner.
Aww.
And then there's... my top tea drinking buddy. Ah, I go get my tea and this is Pinky. I think she's jealous of you, Journal. Today's my birthday. Dad made his best cake. Mum and Gran started the singing. Ben gurgled along. I blew out the candles. And made a wish. Since I was little, I've always dreamed of becoming a writer. This is where you come in, Journal.
A writer writes. No one ever got anything just by wanting it.
I guess that birthday wish was a waste then. Grant said writing is about exploring your thoughts. It helps you unlock your feelings. I'd like to write something that will make Gran smile. She always talks about little acorns growing into big trees. Is that to make you feel better about my height? Or about my writing?
Aww.
I want to write a story, but what kind? A romance? Science fiction? A comedy? A drama? Fairy tales? Wait, we're getting somewhere. A fantasy story.
Eureka!
So, how do I start my fantasy story? Once upon a time. Ugh, no one said this would be easy. A game. From the top. Not so far away, in the lands of Astoria.
Ah!
A place of peace and magic. There lived a girl.
I feel like Grace.
Grace! Everyone knew her by the bright color. Of her purple dress, she was ready to begin her adventure.
Aww.
In fact, she'd been preparing for it her whole life, for she was the only apprentice of the village guardian, Elder Ava. Everyone was very fond of Grace. Her heart was full of curiosity and compassion. The villagers agreed that no one was as kind as her.
Cute. This is so cute. And so, like, I don't know, I'm just like, aww. We get to be Grace.
She was kind and loved taking care of the world around her.
Aww. This game is so cute.
Suddenly, a faint speck of light floated down and began to buzz around Grace. Did you come for my birthday?
Yes.
Oh, Elder Ava's gonna be so happy! Let's head back to the village. The fire. shared Grace's excitement. I was also planning to make Eldorava fruit punch. In secret. Maybe we can find some berries on
the farm. Come on, let's go!
That's a juicy one. Good job, Firefly.
Can I not double jump? Oh.
Shark fins circling below. Phew! We made it, Firefly! And... down!
Woo!
Grace knew many secret paths back to the village.
Okay, there's nothing in there.
Like this one! She loved feeling the roots around her, as if the tree was giving her a gentle hug.
Aww.
Nearly there, Firefly. Just one more little slide. Here we go!
Whee! Oh, it's so cute!
The old cargo barely used.
Were we meant to go this way? I have no idea.
Secret entrance to the village above. Grace couldn't wait to give Elder Ava a hug.
Aww.
She was so proud that her Firefly came. Look, Firefly.
Oh, this is so cute.
Home. The warm lights and the enticing smell. Elder Ava's heart welcomed her. Elder Ava!
Happy birthday, Grace.
I've made a new friend.
One of our sacred fireflies.
Whoa.
This is a very special thing indeed.
Does this mean...
yes.
It's time.
Would you fetch me that box, please?
Ava was sure that Grace would rise to the occasion.
Oh, this is so cute!
Stay with you. Others are fleeting.
Aww.
They will help you overcome any obstacle. Now, your congratulations, new
guardian. But that's you.
Guardian in retirement now. You should head to the shrine tree for the other firefly's blessing. I'll join you shortly, dear. Oh, before I forget, a little something of mine.
Elder Ava reached inside her pocket and handed Grace a gift. Ava's favorite pendant, set with a giant emerald.
Now off you go.
She walked off.
So
it's so wholesome. I can't handle this cuteness.
I can't wait to try out my magic book. And all at once, Grace was surrounded by the hustle and bustle of village life. Throwing stones over the rooftops, but not today. Today, the firefly shrine was waiting.
Look, Grace has the book. Miss.
She looked over her bustling treetop village.
I heard you had a bit of leaf mold.
This was all she knew.
Yeah, Elder Bassus gave me a poultice. Did it work? Cleared it right.
And it was home.
Looks better than ever. Smell that. That's the scent of paradise.
But inside, she was still curious.
Hey, Grace! Happy birthday!
No, you can't have a magic book.
Good to see you, Grace.
But Grace has one. Oh, that's different.
She's special. This game is so cute. I can't handle the wholesomeness.
About the world that may be on. The bridge swayed in the warm breeze. Its slats creaked with a gentle familiarity as Grace crossed it.
Seen that book for a while, Grace. You're off to see the fireflies. Let me get the gate.
Lost. Okay, I kind of fucked that up, but we're gonna go with it.
Let's swing into adventure. Grace crawled through the dank, dark tunnel. It didn't feel like being hugged at all. Rocky cliff face holds no chance for her now.
Whoa!
Sacred bell to announce her arrival. The fireflies, whose ancient energy kept the village safe from harm.
Go on. Show them what you can do. That's it. They're accepting their new color.